Hey, good morning, everyone. And I guess I should add a quick Happy New Year. This is our first Coffee with PC of 2022. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas season and a good New Year celebration. I guess this is the week we kind of get back into the routine. Of course, my routine is always a cup of coffee every morning. Drinking, by the way, thanks to Cindy Smith, some baby's coffee she gave to us for Christmas. So quite enjoying that. Hope you're enjoying maybe your mid-morning break or your mid-morning cup of coffee or whenever you might have a chance to watch this. I thought since this is the first time we kind of communicate and touch base in the new year, I would talk basically about kind of one of the habits that Denise and I have. Sometimes we do it separately, but this year we did it together, and that's to come up with a sort of a theme verse or word for the year. We've done that for a few years, kind of something that we feel like God in the new year is leading us to. And so we, over the last several weeks, have been intentional about praying and thinking and reading separately. And so we decided actually that our theme verses for 2022 would be in Romans chapter 5. Romans chapter 5, particularly verses 3, 4, and 5. Let me just read it for you, and then we'll talk about it a little bit. This is what it says. And not only that, but we also rejoice in our afflictions, because we know that affliction produces endurance, endurance produces proven character, and proven character produces hope. And this hope will not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured out in our hearts through the Holy Spirit who was given to us. So that's our verse. I'm going to memorize it. I think she is too. I might go back all the way to verse 1, memorize those first five verses of Romans chapter 5. And out of that last verse concept is our sort of word for the year, and that's hope. And notice it says a hope that does not disappoint us. Now, why this verse? And this, for some of you might have heard me read it and know exactly why this verse, but for some others of you might be wondering why. Let me just remind you, many of you probably know, if you haven't heard, that late last year we got the news that Denise has cancer, breast cancer particularly, that she felt something and decided to go get it checked out, and unfortunately the biopsy that was done came back, yes, it is cancerous. So that put us on a road of trying to get the treatment she needs. She's actually started that. Actually, this morning, she is in treatment. Wednesday morning, the 5th, she's in treatment for her chemotherapy treatment for the cancer. And so we got the diagnosis. And of course, whenever you get that diagnosis, I've said in sermons before even, you know, your whole life can change with one visit to the doctor. And that's definitely what happened for us, for her. And so we've been walking that journey. And you kind of have this bad news, as it were, and you look for kind of kernels of hopeful news from the doctor's reports, and maybe you want to hope some things, and you want to hope in that sense. What are we saying? We're hoping for good news, for positive things. And the positive at first for us was, hey, this is a very treatable form of cancer. We think we have a very good, effective treatment for it. But we just need to make sure it hasn't spread. So they asked her to do a PET scan, which she did. And unfortunately, it came back that there were spots that showed up on the PET scan, particularly in her spinal column. And so they scheduled her for a bone biopsy to see if that particular spot that showed up on the PET scan was cancer or not. And unfortunately, again, it turned out to be cancerous. And so you never want to hear that cancer has metastasized. Of course, that's not where you want to be with this. And so it was kind of rough. There were some moments where we were hopeful because we got good news, and then there were some moments where it felt kind of crushing because the news wasn't so good. And that's to say nothing of the process. If you have ever been through, or if you have someone close to you that's been through cancer treatment, chemo or radiation, you know that's a difficult road that she is walking, just to physically go through those things. Though it has hope, there's that word again, for having good effect, it's still a very hard and difficult thing for the body to go through. So that's kind of where we were. That's the news, as it were, that informed the end of our 2021. You know, all of that kind of came about late in November into December, when that diagnosis and those tests came together. And so obviously we wanted to find a word in scripture that we can kind of hold on to, something that God would speak to us. And maybe this isn't what was expected. Now, certainly hope is an idea that is expected that we would grab onto in Scripture, and that's in there, and that's why that's our word for this year. But let me do this. Let me explain why, for me, this really jumps out, because I've been convicted for a while, but particularly lately, of sometimes how we approach the idea of hope, how we approach the idea of when we have difficulty, or to use the word here in Romans 5, when we have affliction, which, you know, a disease like this would definitely be that, metastatic disease, certainly an affliction. When we have that, how we approach it, we usually approach it when we think about being hopeful, and in prayer, we approach it praying to God, saying, God, this is a possibility. I could have some bad news, but I pray that I will get good news. And we base our hope, as it were, on the report, the good news we desire, the expected outcome. And that's why this passage just kind of grabbed me. And when I shared it with Denise and we talked about it, we decided to settle on it, because notice it says that those afflictions, it says not only that, we also rejoice in our afflictions, because in our afflictions, this passage tells us God is doing something. Those afflictions produce endurance, and endurance produces proven character, and proven character produces hope. Notice that what produces hope, what starts the process to bring about hope, isn't good news, isn't a prayer answered the way we want. It's actually the opposite. It's the thing that caused us to turn to God in prayer in the first place. And I realized that too often I, and I'm going to generalize and say we, as followers of Jesus Christ, as Christians, as believers, whatever word you'd like to use, we put our hope in certain outcomes. We put our hope in a desired positive result. And when we don't get that desired positive result, we kind of speak about it in ways, but like, you know, well, that's God's will. And we sort of write it off. But this isn't writing off, in this passage, affliction. It's not writing off hope. It's actually saying that that process, that affliction begins, yields the very hope that will not disappoint us. And here's my thought, and here's where I'm going to end up. Here's what I'm praying that God does in my life, what Denise and I will be praying that God does in our lives through whatever it is that she will go through this year and have to face, is that God will build in us this kind of hope that verse 5 says, this hope does not disappoint us. Why? Not because we got the answer we wanted, but because God's love has been poured into our hearts. What's the basis of this hope then? It's not circumstance. It's not result. It's not answered prayer. It's God Himself. It's in affliction, finding out, no matter what happens in the outcome, my hope ultimately isn't in what I want. My hope ultimately is in who God is, and the salvation that He's given, and in the promises that He's made, even in the midst of difficulty and affliction. And so that kind of hope will not disappoint us, because what we know, Proverbs says this, I used this in a sermon not too long ago, hope deferred makes the heart sick. And if we go about placing our hope in certain outcomes that we can't control, like a medical diagnosis or medical progression, if we place our hope in certain desired results, when we don't get those desired results, that hope will disappoint us. That hope, which is deferred, which doesn't come to be, makes our hearts sick. But hope, like Paul talks about, hope in God and what He has done, hope in Christ, and hope that's based on the love God has poured out in our hearts, that we understand has nothing to do with whether or not He answers a certain prayer or causes certain circumstances to come to be. That kind of hope will not disappoint us. And I want that hope to grow in me, no matter what happens. Now let me be clear and say our prayer will continue to be for healing, for remission, for positive result from every treatment that she takes, for the most minimal of side effects of any of it that are possible for her, in spite of having to go through this to feel well, and that on the other side of some of these treatments, we'll begin to see and continue to see, I should say, good and positive things. We actually had a very encouraging visit yesterday when she went to see our oncologist. So we see some tangible, we might say, evidence of hope in the midst of this affliction. But ultimately, what God is saying that affliction breeds is something in me, endurance and proven character that builds hope, because I know God is with me. He never leaves me nor forsakes me. I don't have that confidence based on any particular outcome, but on who He is and what He has demonstrated. He's poured out His love in our hearts through the Holy Spirit who's been given to us. This is the hope that we have, the love of God poured out on us, and that's the basis of our hope. Yes, again, hope deferred makes the heart sick. Let me just turn over there. I just want to read the whole thing to you because I did mention the second part earlier. Here's what Proverbs 13, verse 12. Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but desire fulfilled is a tree of life. And so as we think about hope, that's what we want. We want that tree of life, don't we? We want to know, and what's the tree of life? It's the gift of God through Jesus Christ, His love poured out in our hearts. That's the hope that we're holding on to. But this kind of hope does not disappoint. That's my word of the day. These are our verses of the year that Denise and I are holding on to. I wanted to share a little bit of that with you. I said something on Sunday to some of our folks, and let me add that to those of you here. We have been so encouraged and supported and loved, and people have been kind and generous and prayerful, and we are so grateful for all of that support for her, for us, as we've kind of begun to walk this road. We don't take that for granted, and we want you to know it means the world to us. We're thrilled to have a church family that has been so supportive, and you know, I guess after pouring our lives in here for over 22 years, we feel like that investment in some ways of that, those relationships that were built are evidence of how you're responding, and we're grateful for that. And we're going to keep hoping for a lot of good things. I hope whatever your year holds, that you'll find the same source of hope that God has poured out His love into your heart through Jesus Christ, because that ultimately is in spite of the circumstances of life. That's all that we need, and that's sometimes all that we have. But as we're learning, and maybe you've learned, that's enough. Hey, listen, those are my thoughts for this first Wednesday, first Coffee with PC of 2022. Hope you have a great rest of your day, a great rest of your week. Love to have you join us in worship on Sunday, 9 a.m. We'll be in person and online. We're continuing tonight. We're picking back up our journey through the Hebrew Bible, our study of the Old Testament, but looking at the Hebrew order and the Hebrew, and from that perspective. We'll be in the book of Joshua tonight. Love to have you join us for that. It's not online. It is online. There is a Zoom link. You can get to that. But we also post it afterwards on our church website. So if you're not able to be there in person or watch the Zoom tonight, you can check it out later. So it's been a great study. I've really enjoyed both of the studies, Acts on Sunday morning and the Hebrew Bible on Wednesday night. Love to have you be a part of those. But until then, I hope you have a great first week of 2022 as you get back into the routine of things. And I hope things are going well for you. I look forward to worshiping with you and to serving alongside you and to seeing what the rest of this year holds for us. Take care, everybody. God bless you all.